So just like we had present values involving a single life like AX, AX bar in case of life insurance payment, or probably AX or AX double dot or AX bar in case of annuity payments, which we talked about as the present value of one that is received for a person who's aged X forever. Similarly, when I'm looking at this AX, it is more to do with the annuity where we were talking about the value of one that is coming out every year, either at the beginning or at either in arrears or in advance for a particular. Up as long as the person aged X is alive. Now, the same kind of mechanisms we are looking for even if two lives are coming into picture. So, simply put, if I am assuming the joint status, a status being some U, which could be either the joint lifetime or the last survivor status, either of them. Once this status, until this particular status is failing, the payments are getting made. So we know the probability density function associated with this status. Once we know whatever, okay, if I am looking at dollar one being paid, let's say on the failure of this status or on the failure of this status. What do I mean by failure of this status? Probably the first life has died. Whereas in this case, the last life has died. So whatever, if the dollar one is getting paid on the failure of a particular status, we get the present value of that as nothing but V to the power of TU. Either TXY or TXY bar. So I can very well find out the expected present value, which will directly come to me, right? If I'm here, the expected present value, probably I'm calling it as A bar because I'm looking at it with respect to continuous lifetime. So this I'm looking at it with respect to infinite V power T F of T dt. This is what we had, and this f of t I'll take it with respect to tu. So if I'm looking at, just for example, let's say I want AXY. XY means the first to die. So I could have taken it as 0 to infinite f of t v power t. What is f of t? The density function. In case of joint lifetime, let's try to recollect that the density function, if you remember, the distribution function, right? The distribution function of T, we have directly got it as 1 minus of TPX times 1 TPY. This, in other way, if I am trying to do the, if I'm trying to find out the density function for the same, it is coming out as minus TPX times, what is the derivative of this? Minus TPY mu y plus T. Similarly, minus TPY times, the derivative of this is minus TPX mu x plus T. So, in a summation, this density function is becoming integral 0 to T V power T. TPX TPY times mu x plus t plus mu y plus t. This is what is the typical value of my AXY, A bar XY. Similarly, if I'm looking at A bar XY bar, which is the survival. So what did we get as a part of the survival? We have computed the distribution function there as 1 minus of TPX minus TPY plus TPX times TPY. right? This is what was the computation. So I can take the differentiation of this entire stuff. So the differentiation of minus tpx is going as tpx mu x plus t. For tpy, it is going as tpy mu x plus mu y plus t. And for tpx, tpy, we have just now computed, right? For tpx, tpy, we have just now computed it as minus tpx, tpy times mu x plus t plus mu y plus t. So which is nothing but, this is nothing but this part is f of the density function, right? So it is directly coming out as integral 0 to infinite v power t. This part tpx mu x plus t is nothing but ftx, right? This is f of t for tx. Then we are having f of ty, f of t for ty. Then we are also having f of t for txy. So it's as good as, it is coming out as ax bar plus ay bar minus axy bar, which means the expected present value of the last survivor status is coming out as the summations of the expected present values of the individual lives minus the expected present value of the joint life function. It's a very important relationship for us to work out. So we can quite comfortably work out AXYs, A bar X, AXY bars and all those. Similarly, just like the way we have found out the expected values, we could even find out the variances as well, because for the computation of the variance, we are simply looking at as integral of 0 to infinite. Instead of v power t, we are taking as v power t squared, which is v power t whole squared, which is v power 2t times, again, f of t, let's say for txy, minus expected value of x squared minus expected value of x whole squared, which we have already got this this part. So which is nothing but, this comes out as 2a bar xy, which we have, wherein we can very well take this 2 as a subscript, which is nothing but a changed interest rate, 1 plus I whole squared minus 1. So this comes out as 2a bar xy minus a bar xy whole squared. So this is exactly the same way we have done even in case of single life functions. The same logic, even if I am looking at the variance with respect to the last survivor status also, I will call it as 2a bar xy bar minus a bar xy bar whole squared. Which in a way, probably for each one, again, I can write it 2a bar xy. I can very well write it as 2a bar x plus 2a bar y minus 2a bar xy. Similarly, this part I could have written a bar xy, I could have written it as a bar x plus a bar y minus a bar xy whole squared. So this would have given me the variance with respect to the joint lifetime function, especially when I am looking at from a continuous life perspective. Similarly, we could look at the similar kind of exercises and examples even when I am looking at from a discrete life perspective, where the focus is on curtailed lifetime rather than the complete lifetime. Which means that the present value would have been v to the power of ku plus 1. Now the same logic again, the expected present value, which is going as axy, this will go with v power k plus 1 times qxy k with a pipe. Means the lives x and y, they are surviving up to time k, and after that at least one of the lives is expiring. So this entire thing, I'm summing up over k to infinite, k equal to 0 to infinite. So at the end of the year of the death, so in the kth year, k plus 1th year, between k and k plus 1 year, this life, one of the lives is exiting, which means the benefit would be paid at the end of the year k plus 1. That's the reason we are discounting it by k plus 1. Similarly, if I'm looking at the variance part, it again comes out as 2axy minus axy whole square, which remained the same. The same logic, if I'm going with the last survivor, axy bar, I can very well, first of all, write it as ax bar plus ay bar minus axy. Sorry, ax plus ay minus axy. The same logic I can very well extend it. Right now the axy, we have it. This is the one which we are talking of, axy. Ax, ay, we already know in terms of individual single life functions. Again, that will help us in determining, finding out the values of axy, axy bar, etc. Here, one interesting point, especially when we are computing the reserves, and that too for the last survivor. Look at it. I really need to know whether one life is still existing or two lives are still existing. The reason being, the policy will continue until the second life is existing, right? But the reserving, see, if both of them are alive, probably the chances of death are much, much longer. I mean, the chances that the claim has to be paid will be much, much for a longer period. But if one party has already died, the policy is coming closer towards the claim payment. So this is where I really need to have a good understanding, especially for setting the reserve, whether both the lives are alive or at least one of them is dead. Because simply look at the reserve, right? Probably if I'm looking at from a net premium reserve perspective itself, look at this. If at all I'm talking about both X and Y being the last survivor kind of a policy, if at all I'm looking at both of them are alive, probably I would have looked at it as the future payment, ax plus t, y plus t, right? Both of them being alive, minus whatever the premium that we have collected at the beginning of the policy for both this. And I'm even looking at the premium payment also under the assumption that both of them are alive. Whereas when I'm looking at the same reserve setting, in case one of them has already died, let's say Y has already died, then our computation is directly becoming AX plus T, because Y has already died. I'm looking at only the X being dying. So this would have simplified my calculation, and probably even the premium payment will happen only up to X being alive, because Y is already dead. Now in this logic, if I'm seeing, when we have computed ax plus t, y plus t bar, both the lives being alive bar, we have simply mentioned it as ax plus ay minus axy. Now here we are directly looking at only ax plus t. What we are clearly seeing is, if at all the first death has occurred, the reserve has to go up drastically. This value is here, this number is going to be much higher here. So which means the reserve requirement has to drastically go up in case one person has died, because the chances that the claim payment is coming more and more closer is increasing. So that's the reason the reserve requirement typically goes up. Whatever we have discussed in case of insurance policies, the same can be applied even to the case of annuities also. The same logic, just like you have done it in case of individual life, because for us annuity payment is you are typically making payment of one every period until the life is existing. So we know that one relationship we know the relationship ATU is nothing but 1 minus of V per TU by delta, especially for the bar. Otherwise, I am taking it as D. So which is directly working out for me as 1 minus AU bar divided by delta. So in case of a discrete, I'll take it as D. In case of continuous, I'm taking it as delta. Similarly, the variance also, I could very well take it as variance of 1 minus V per TU by delta, which is working out as 1 by delta squared variance of V per TU. And I already know the variance of TU is nothing but 1 by delta squared times 2 A bar U minus A bar U whole squared. So we can very well see either in the continuous case or in the discrete case. So probably if I'm looking at it in a discrete case, let's say in advance kind of payment, the mean is going to be nothing but 1 minus AU by D. The variance is going to be 1 by D squared times 2 AU minus AU squared, AU whole squared. The same logic, we can do it even if the payments are made in arrear. So it's only a practice with the numericals that is very much required in this. The basic concepts remain exactly one and the same, right? So just to quickly look at a few important functions here. When I'm talking about a person whose age is two lives X and Y surviving up to time T, I could directly take it as TPX times TPY because this is our independent lives. But when we are looking at it from the perspective of the last survivor kind of a status, at least the probability that at least one of them is alive. Then I am looking at it like 1 minus TQX times 1 minus TQY, which in other way is nothing but, okay, the survival for T for age X, survival for T periods for age Y, and then a joint survival up to age T for both X as well as Y. So wherever this is required, this is the formula that is working out. When I am taking TQXY, I can very well take it as 1 minus of TPX times TPY. Similarly, when I am talking of TQXY bar, I could very well look at it as 1 minus of TPXY bar, which will directly give me TQX times TQY. So these relationships, one thing we have to be comfortable with. And at the same time, when I'm looking at the four major summation variables, let's say if I'm looking at a bar xy, it is nothing but the integral between 0 to infinite v per t, and I'm taking the density function associated with it, which is going as tpxy dt. And when I'm looking at xy bar, I'll take it as v per t times tqxy or tp 1 minus tqxy or tpxy bar dt. Similarly, when I'm looking at a bar xy, I'm looking at it with respect to the death part. So v per t tpxy, people being surviving up to time period t. And after that dying, any one of the lives typically dying. Whereas when I'm looking at A bar, XY bar, I'm talking about a situation where all the lives TQX, right? TQX. And then TPY right? Y alive for T period, Q died, mu Y plus T means Q has already died by the time T has reached, P is just died. What is the joint, what is the probability for that? Similarly, P has already died, sorry, P has already, X has already died. Then we are talking of P, T, P, Y, sorry. Here there are two, either the person is X has already died and we are talking about Y just dying during the period T, or Y already died and X just died. So this is what will become the probability density function for computing A bar XY. So a typical simplification of these numericals will give us a lot of comfort level in solving a good number of numericals associated with the computation of the premiums or computation of the reserves and various other aspects regarding the joint lives, right?